Here we go. Top story of the day. This is following what we were discussing yesterday. Voting for New Jersey online betting bill scheduled for the 5th and 9th of January. The forecast of Joe Brennan Jr., the iMega chairman and New Jersey gaming insider, has been validated. He tweets today, quote, NJ Senate gaming panel to vote on new iGaming bill this Thursday, 10 a.m., local time I expect. Assembly set to vote January 9 on the bill. The Senate panel in question is the Senate and General Assembly Government Wagering, Tourism, and Historic Preservation Committee. If the bill succeeds in the committee, it will go before both houses of the state legislature the following Monday, the last day of voting for the current session. In addition, the Casino Association of New Jersey, presided by Bob Griffin, CEO of Trump Entertainment, mind you, will convene tonight at 5 p.m. Eastern to explore the current gaming climate further, and the impact of the Department of Justice's reinterpretation of the Wire Act will bear. So there you have it. There is an update on the Eastern Front, which is not quiet. Nothing quiet on the Eastern Front, ladies and gentlemen. Moving right along, and I'll comment on these stories a little later when we're done. Moving right along, second news story of the day. Groupe Bernard Tapie lawyer, this is from yesterday. Groupe Bernard Tapie lawyer gives interview and update about Full Tilt Poker. Benam Dayanim, a Washington, D.C. based lawyer with the firm of Axen, Veltrop, Harkrider, LLP, and legal representative of Groupe Bernard Tapie in the United States, spoke to Chad Holloway of Poker News in an interview released on Monday. When asked if there have been any noteworthy updates regarding the ongoing negotiations among FTP, DOJ, and GBT, Dayanim reports that there is, quote, nothing new. He describes the process and history of these triangular proceedings, how Full Tilt Poker agreed to forfeit its assets to the Department of Justice, who will then sell them to the Groupe Bernard Tapie, and how, quote, negotiating and memorializing a definitive agreement with the DOJ that essentially sets out all of the details surrounding the terms to the letter agreement, end quote, is what GBT is presently focused on. Dayanim is reluctant to lay out a timeline for the process's resolution and limits himself to say that he hopes it can all be concluded by the early part of the year. I presume he's referring to this one. Dayanim addresses speculation over the new ownership structure of Full Tilt Poker and whether existing owners would be able to retain partial interest. Quote, the agreement with the DOJ contemplates that the GBT would retain majority and controlling interest in the company, he says. The DOJ also prohibits Full Tilt members from retaining or acquiring any ownership interest in the new company. Namely, the directors are not permitted to have ownership interest going forward. End quote. Any minority interest pursued further by the current owners would have to be entirely passive, says Dayanim, when asked about the possibility of offering shares of the new company to some indebted players as an alternative method of repayment. Dayanim refused to comment specifically, nor would he agree to speculate on the specifics of how the company would go about indemnifying worldwide players. Finally, Dayanim confirms that under GBT's directorship, the new Full Tilt Poker would seek licenses by the Alderney Gambling Control Commission and the Kahnawake Gaming Commission, and he expressed a hope that this would happen expediently. Quote, Alderney is already familiar with the technology, the software, the gaming platform, and all of that, which is a large part of the process. Wow, so there's a Full Tilt update. I mean, I think it's mostly a GBT update, because of course you can only speak on the behalf of Groupe Bernard Tapie. But I think when we say it's a Full Tilt update, that's just kind of an umbrella term referring to the Full Tilt situation. Obviously, Full Tilt is involved. But there's more to say about that. Finally, Again, this is also an update from what we were discussing yesterday. PokerStars agrees to negotiate new rake changes with players. In response to the mass sit-out carried out by many of its players as protest over the new rake changes, PokerStars issued the following statement to PokerStrategy.com. Quote, "We will work with player representatives on a better rake system later this month. We hope to agree on a rake structure that will benefit a majority of players, both professional and recreational." End quote. The January 1st sit-out involved occupying a high number of cash game tables simultaneously, only to sit out from play, with the intention of slowing down the room's game flow and rake revenue. Prior to today's statement, PokerStars had suspended or locked the accounts of some protesters. There has not yet been any official update over the lifting of these restrictions, at least to my knowledge, and I was checking right before publishing this. I'm asking, like, has there been an update? Like, people get their accounts unlocked. No word yet, at least. But if anyone can prove me wrong and report any change in that, by all means, please. So there you have it. That is essentially the daily news update.